Maria. I'm going to show you today's recipe. It's going to be homemade chicken, Italian-style chicken pot pie. Now, you can make this any way you want according to my basic ingredients. Always try to keep, like, the pie crust and the cream of potato or cream of whichever I want to use. So, anyway, what you're going to need is your choice of meat. Determine your family's needs as far as meat, whatever. I have some pre-Italian sauce chicken breast that are already in a little packet, and we got them on sale. I cooked them in oil. Now, I know I'm going to get hacked for saying, hey, I'm not sure we're going to be eating healthier. Well, we are, but I'm slightly going to modify that. Okay, moving on. You're also going to need either one or two cans of mixed canned vegetables, or you can use frozen vegetables. I use cream of potato, but you can use cream of mushroom, cream of onion. I think cream of potato or mushroom tastes way better. They also have at the store Campbell's Great for Cooking cream of mushroom with roasted garlic. I'm actually going to use this in my green bean casserole. You're also going to need two pie crusts. That you get in the refrigerated section, you're going to need to let this sit out as you're cooking because it needs to, you know, get to room temperature. You can use some cheese, garlic, whichever you like. Okay, so what you're going to do is put your meat in the skillet, drain it. I've already done that. I actually had about that much leftovers from the other night, and I did turkey. But what I did was I started with the cream of potato, the mixed vegetables drained. And when I added the cream of potato, I put a little bit of milk, a little bit of water. I always do that. And while I'm doing that, I cook the chicken and let it brown and get it all the way cooked. And as you can tell, and besides that, the milk helps it fall or thicken up. If I had onion, I would add onion or garlic. Okay. So now that that's pretty thick, I have my pie crust over here, honey, if you want to come over here. I tried to shoot this video 3 times, and we've got bloopers. I mean, careful not to just cut myself. This is a Pyrex. This is about 24 centimeters pie thing. You can also use a square one if you want to. I've got one of those also. Now, also something you're going to do, I did do this time, you can take a little bit of butter and melt it and put it for your bottom and on your top pie crust. And what you're going to do is unroll it. I like to get rolled out on a piece of wax or parchment paper. As you can tell, the dough is pretty easy to roll with. I'm thinking heavy. I'm going to spray this down. You can either use cooking spray or the flour spray. I'm just going to use this because it's just easier. Keep it from sticking. And of course, it's really hot in here. Preheat your oven to about 350 to 400 degrees. I got it for 400. I usually do that. And what you're going to do is you're going to make sure it fits your pie. My husband, when he first made it, he used the square one, but I'm using the round one. I would use this. I've got like two of these, one for dessert and one for casseroles. And I get your butter. Okay, now I'm going to have him back up because I forgot something. And you're going to get the mixture. I'm going to bring it over here. And whenever I'm making this much, I usually have enough for another pie. So then I have to go to the store and get some more. Or you can, if you have extra, you can also add noodles and make it a good little dish. So, okay. You want to cook all of this. Once your meat is done, cook all of it together until it thickens up and let it maybe sit for like 5 minutes. And I'm just taking a ladle. Looks really yummy. I got it. He's trying to help me, but now I know this isn't anybody's type of food, but I love comfort food and I love cooking it. But it's hard to do it when you're trying to lose weight, and we we haven't really succeeded. Now, I still got a little bit left. I like to make little mini pies out of it. Now, I'm going to run my salt and pepper. I got tired of pulling with the salt and the little salt shaker, so I took an empty container and just put a little bit of salt. I have to be careful with the pepper because almost every time I do that, I sneeze. Now, also, my husband does this. He adds his Creole seasoning to his dish when he makes this plate. I don't because it's a little bit. I have just a touch. Okay? You can also add breadcrumbs if you want to. You can add, the fried onions if you would really want to make it yummy. And I'm going to top it with cheese. Or you can put the cheese. I did put a little bit of cheese into the mixture a while ago. Try to even it out. Okay, and then you're going to take your second pie crust. Now, I try to do this like a professional, and Lord knows I'm not a professional. Recipe. I mean, it turned out really, really well. This is probably, like, too big for my pie. But, you know, like I said, you just kind of work with it. Not a professional here, but this is just the way we roll here. Okay, but the key is, I did learn in making this, you want to make sure that the edges are sealed. You want to take an eye. I put more, and I do this when I'm baking, like, fruit pies and stuff anyway. And then you're going to bake this at between 350 to 400. I would stick to 350 depending on what your oven says. And then you're going to bake it until this is nice and golden. And then, because your insides are already cooked. And then you're ready to go. So, that's my recipe. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'm sorry I was all over the place with the ingredients. If you want a list of the ingredients, let me know. And I'll do a blog post on my blog, which I hope to resume soon. So, anyway, happy eating. And if you want any more cooking recipes, I have pork tenderloin and roast coming up the way I do it in a slow cooker.